Welcome back, Booksmiths. My name is Angie, and on this channel, we typically talk about writing AI-assisted books. But today, we're going to continue our look into the web-based organizational platform, Notion. I'll show you the basic and media blocks and hopefully give you a few tips at personalizing Notion along the way. As usual, you'll find a link to this Notion document below in the video description. I've also included timestamps to help you navigate to the sections of the video that you're most interested in. Now, let's get started. Here you can see my previous video where I talked about Notion. Additionally, down here, you can see the template that I shared. So I included a Second Brain for Independent Publishers template that you can take a look at. And then I walked through it a bit more in depth in this video. So if you missed it, I highly recommend going back and taking a look. For those of you who are new to Notion, as long as you are logged into your Notion account, there should be a button in the upper right-hand corner that says duplicate, and you should be able to add that Notion template into your actual Notion account. And then here is some recommended reading if you decide to use the Second Brain or if you want to build your own, some books by Tiago Forte, as well as my favorite book on Getting Things Done by David Allen. So what we're going to do today is we are going to look at the different types of blocks. So we've got basic blocks, we've got media blocks, and there's embeds. Okay. And so basic blocks. So you have just regular text. I'll hit enter, go to the next line, and I can just start talking. Additionally, you can also add a new page. So if I click on this link, it says new page. If I click on this link, it'll actually take me to this page. I have the ability to click this button and have just a blank page that I can start from fresh on. I can also start it with AI. I can import information. Most likely, this is probably going to be like a CSV or a document of some sort. You can use templates. There's tons that are built into Notion itself, as well as there are lots of Notion templates you can get everywhere off the internet, from Etsy to just searching Notion templates. I know there's quite a few that I've seen even as Facebook ads. And then you can also do a table or click more. One thing I want to show you that it took me a while to figure out is if you come up here to this, you can actually make your page full width. And this is how I usually present my pages because I like to use columns. But right here, you have the ability to do full width. And then there's additional items here on the right-hand side. You can make your text smaller. You can also change whether it is serif or sans serif or mono, and the ability to turn it into a wiki. I have never used it as a wiki. I probably should at some point, but to this day, I have not. So let's go ahead and we'll go back. So you can either hit the back button or you can come up here and click the breadcrumbs. Okay. And a quick way of adding a new page is to hit /, and type the word page. And then you have another new page. Okay. And then I'll come back to the breadcrumbs again. And we're back to our initial page. Okay. We also have the ability to do these checklist items. If you actually check it, it turns the box to blue, gives it a white checkbox, and actually crosses it out. A quick tip for these is you can either go to a to-do list item and hit enter, and it'll give you a new one. So we'll call this 2-3. If you don't want to continue, hit enter twice, and now you're back to usual. Another way of doing this is to hit the open square bracket, close square bracket, and then hit the space key, and it'll also give you a checkbox. So 2-4. Okay, next, we have different types of headings. So we've got heading ones, we've got heading twos, and we have heading threes. If you come back up here, you can see I usually include a table of contents to make finding things in these documents, because they tend to get rather long, and much easier. So you can see our heading one, and then also the links up there connect to the heading two and the heading three as well. This kind of gives you an idea of how large they are compared to the rest of the text. A quick way to turn text into a heading. So let's turn this back into text. So I'm going to click these little, it looks like a domino to me. So I'll click the little domino. I'll come up here, turn into, and I'll change it back to text. So you can change back and forth. And then I'll hit this again. I'll come turn into, and I'll turn it back into heading one. So this is a quick way to change your text. So with bulleted items, you've got basically what you would see in a word processor. Again, if you hit enter, it'll give you another one. So we'll put bulleted list three. Okay. And then if you don't want it again, hit enter twice. I've also noticed if you do a dash and you hit the space bar, it will also give you a bullet. Okay. Moving on, we have numbered lists. I'm sure you can guess that if I click here, it's going to give me another number. Another way of doing this is to put the number in, hit the space key, and then it will also give you the next numbered item. Okay, down to one of my favorite things. I love using what's called a toggle list. What a toggle list does is it allows you to hide information. So it's still on the page. It's just not taking up as much room, because I know you guys have seen my Notion documents. They are rather lengthy. And sometimes, especially if I'm doing something that's book related, like I have a list of beats and I want to put all my beats on the same page. How many chapters, how many scenes is that? A lot of times I'll put my scene beats inside of a toggle list. That way I can close them and open them as I need. I don't have to see them when I don't want to see them, but they're still there. We have, and I've actually, just to make it a little easier to see, because normally when you have a toggle list, it's white in the background, but I've actually added some color. So if you come down here to color and come to background, you can actually change the color of the background. But I just wanted to make it a little easier for us to see it. So you can open them both up. You can put text in here. You can put all sorts of stuff inside of these boxes, these toggle lists. And then when you're done looking at them, you can go ahead and you can close them up. Usually how I create a toggle list is I'll put whatever I want for my toggle list. I'll come over here to the domino and then I will hit toggle list. And then it puts where you can either click inside of it and start typing. And here you actually can see it in its normal state with no background. But you can just start typing inside of it, or you can add things into it. And it's really easy to move things around within Notion. That's both a good thing and a bad thing. Occasionally, you'll end up grabbing something you don't really want to grab. So just be cautious. Okay, so let's move down here. This is a table, and this is like a normal table. We have the ability to have databases, but we also have the ability to have these tables to put just very basic information in. So if you want to have a header row, come here to your options. You can turn off the header row. You can also turn off a header column. And then there's some additional information there. You can make changes. If you want to add additional columns, you come here. If you want to add additional rows, you come down here. Okay, moving along. So this is a quote. I've actually got this quote set a little bit larger than usual. Let's see. How did I do this? I think I came over here, and I went to quote size. So this is the default size. And oops, come up down here. This is the large size. Just adding a quote to your page, making it nice and pretty. This is really good if you're doing a dashboard for like your day and you want to put one of your favorite quotes. This is one of those ways of doing it. Okay. Also, we have dividers. So it's a way of breaking things up and you're able to move them around quite easily. So just click on the dominoes and drag it around. And something that you'll see me use, well, every time I have a Notion document is I love having these callouts. What a callout is, it's just a way for you to be able to draw attention to a specific area. If you look up here, all of these are actually callouts. And so it's got a little icon, it's got a title, and then it's got some text inside of it. So you can use regular text. This is the table of contents block, or I've got a bulleted list block with some links. Now, oops. One thing I will bring to your attention, this block is actually linked to my other blocks. So I have the ability to have blocks that connect to others, and you only, when you update one, it updates all of them. So let me duplicate. Actually, that's not what I wanted to do. But it's called copy and sync. So you can copy it and then you synchronize all of them. And you can see I have it connected to 9 other pages. So let's go here and we'll go ahead and delete it because I don't need it. Now, if you end up deleting something that you don't want to, you can always hit Control Z or Command Z if you're on the Mac to be able to undo what you've done. So back to callouts. So really quite easy for you to change your icon. I like to keep my stuff color coordinated, and then you have the ability to pick a regular emoji, or over here, you have the ability to pick one of the normal, I want to call them emojis, businessy ones. And then you also have the ability to add a custom emoji as well. Just remember, if you were on the free plan, that you have a maximum file size of 5 megabytes. Within the callout, again, you have a header, and then you have the ability to add additional text. You can also put other things, like quite often I'll put databases or a database view inside of a callout to make it stand out more. Now we're going to go through the media blocks. And as you can guess, they involve different types of media. So the first one I will show you here is this is a image block, and you can actually take this image and you can make it smaller or you can make it bigger. We'll go ahead and we'll add another one. Okay, so I'm going to do a forward slash. I'm going to put the word image and here we go. We could upload a file. We could embed one from a link. And then we also have access to unslash and from Giphy. So I'll just put this one right here. So I'll just make it a little bit smaller because it's taken up quite a bit of the page. One thing I will do real quick, because I forgot to add this in here, I want to show you how to create columns. So I'm going to come back up here to my media and give myself a little bit of space. I'm going to type forward slash and column. Okay, so I have the ability to put 2 columns, 3 columns, 4 columns, or 5 columns. Since I have 2 pictures, I'll actually go ahead and use 2 columns. And then I'll just go ahead and grab them from the domino. And if I move my mouse, so down here, you can see that the blue line goes all the way across the page. But if I come up to my column, it only goes halfway across the page. That's how you know if you're in the column or not. So I'll go ahead and drop that there. And I will grab my second one. I'll come over here and add it here. So now I have my 2 columns and I've got my 2 images, 1 in each column. Okay. So we also have the ability to add embed links. So if I came here to embed, I think I want to use the word link. There we go. Let's just do it the hard way. Okay. So web bookmark is actually what it's called. That's why I couldn't find it. So we want to do a web bookmark, and then you can add a URL. Okay, let's move on. You have the ability to add audio as well. And I went and actually uploaded something to SoundCloud just so we would have something to work with. So this is the audio from a YouTube short video that I did a little while ago, as well as the background image. And so if you click on this, you should be able to listen to the audio. So this here is a code block. And this is actually HTML. If you were to turn this into a web page, it would say hello world in a H1 heading. To do this, like most other things, forward slash, and you'll want to put code. The really cool thing about a code block is that you have the ability to come over here and hit copy. And this makes it really super simple to be able to copy and paste things. So if you're keeping your prompts inside of Notion, sometimes it's a good idea to keep it in a code block because then it's easy to copy. Okay, let's move on down. So this is a link to a document. So if we click this, it will give us a hard time. Actually, yep. So I am actually embedded this OpenRouter Pycing document that I created not that long ago. I think it was maybe last week. And so I just created it into a PDF and there we go. So you can also embed documents. So use cases for an author. So you can embed your book cover. If it's not over 5 megabytes, you might actually wish to link to your cover instead. You can also embed files such as PDFs or Word docs or anything else that you can think of. Okay, so let's move down. We're going to talk about embeds, and I've only put a couple examples of embeds here because there are tons of different things that you can embed into Notion to make the system work for you and make it work better. Plus, I see that embeds are usually used on like dashboards. So the main page that you would use to get to everything else that you have. So I went ahead and I put in a clock embed. This is actually where I got this from. And of course, I can't remember. There we go. Indify. So this basically is taking this entire web page and turning it into an embed. So this is from Indify, and I believe this one is as well. So I did a quick countdown timer in Indify. Indify is a site that allows you to create up to 6 embeds for free. And they have a couple other different types of embeds as well. So this is a countdown timer to Halloween, which is my favorite holiday. You also have the ability to embed files. In this instance, it's Google Drive, but I believe that they have connections to Dropbox and other systems as well. So this is a Google Drive file. And then I just added a couple more resources here for you to go take a look at. Some are specifically for authors and others are a bit more broad. So I think that's it for this video. So we've covered the basic blocks. We've talked about the different media blocks, as well as we've talked about embeds. Another thing that we need to talk about, and this is only if you guys are interested, so let me know down in the comments if you guys are interested in learning more about databases. Databases are a great way to keep track of information, especially if it's attached to a specific thing. So you've got a book, your book has these number of items. So it's got a title, it's got a subtitle, it's got a pen name, and all of these things that you have to keep track of. What's the price of your book? What's the link to my book? Let me know in the comments below if you would be interested in me doing a very basic tutorial on how to work in databases. If not, that's perfectly okay. I love databases. Did you go and download Notion? And let me also know if you had time to test out that Second Brain for Independent Publishers template. I'd love to hear if you like it or if you want something else. So just let me know. I love creating Notion templates. It's a lot of fun. You guys have an amazing day, and I'll talk to you again soon.